Nature is full of all sorts of fascinating creatures. One of these such creatures is the abscondit noctiparum, known most commonly by its name, the Josh. The Josh begins its day, like many other creatures, by awakening 5 hours after the sun has. The now alert Josh puts on a protective covering and prepares to leave its lair in search of food. After a short journey from its shelter, the Josh spots a vulnerable prey. A lone bag of off-brand Doritos basking in the sun. It's completely unaware of his presence. If you watch closely, you can see... Where'd he go? Where'd he go? Oh, I see him. He's over there. Shh. He's preparing to strike. Ooh. A quick but brutal battle ensues, and Josh is victorious. The Josh participates in several other interesting activities throughout the day. A typical Josh can go nearly 15 days without social contact from any other living being. Conserving energy is one of the Josh's top survival priorities, so social interaction is avoided at almost all costs. Joshes in the wild can often be seen spending their time reading, writing, and lying on the floor for hours upon hours in a near-death-like state watching YouTube. Despite this extreme lack of activity, Joshes have an incredibly powerful and athletic physique capable of amazing feats of physical prowess. Another one of Joshes' impressive traits is his incredible mental capacities. Joshes are excellent problem solvers, capable of focusing on a problem for nearly 4 consecutive minutes, given the correct circumstances. The most fascinating part, however, of the Josh is the complicated inner machinations of his mind. They are an enigma. Join me now as we go behind the mask.
It all started in the fourth grade with my best friends, Justin and Alex. They didn't mean to, and I'm not mad at them. It's me I can't forgive. They were much bigger than I was, and they liked to remind me every single day. A constant barrage of jokes and insults about how scrawny I was bombarded me.
I could feel my columns continually crumbling beneath me,
but was powerless to save them.
I didn't have a chance.
After they left the picture, I spent the next 7 years recovering from the voice inside my head that they put there. I spent most of that time making it worse.
Trying so hard to get a girlfriend to validate myself and falling flat every single time.
Hating everything about who I was. The fact that I can't gain weight. Or that I'm not tall.
Or strong. Or athletic.
Or funny. Or charming.
Or deep. Or smart, or otherwise talented or attractive.
I spent so much time wallowing in myself, being bitter and furious at the world and myself for the way that I was,
making everyone in my family miserable.
I hated life almost as much as I hated myself.
I hid behind a persona that I made.
A happy-go-lucky jester, so that no one would catch on, because I was ashamed.
And everyone seemed to buy it.
They never understood that I was my own greatest joke.
I kept it up for almost all of those 7 years, until my first girlfriend broke up with me.
I should have seen it coming from miles away. but man, was it a slap in the face.
Couldn't keep the facade up any longer.
I made a conscious decision that I didn't want to live like this anymore.
I felt like someone was pushing a heavy boot against my neck and digging their heel into my throat for almost the entire year that followed.
It took hours and hours of working through my feelings instead of being afraid of them and more heavenly help than I deserved. After an agonizing year, I emerged victorious.
I held the banner of happiness high above my head for the first time since the fourth grade, and I loved every single moment of it.
Life was perfect. I felt so good about myself. You could have called me an ugly idiot right to my face, and I would have smiled and told you to have an amazing day.
The character that I made wasn't just a role anymore.
I could finally feel like Alex and Justin were wrong.
Until the insomnia set in. It's genetic. Both my dad and grandpa have it. That doesn't change the fact that I wasn't ready.
Knowing I was susceptible, I tried so hard not to trigger it. But for the last 3 months,
I've had 4 nights where I actually got a good night's sleep, and 3 of them were during spring break. I spend almost every night staring into the shadowed corners of my closet, feeling the yearning for sleep pulling on my body while my brain refuses to comply. I feel like a wrung out old towel, like I'm clawing my way through my life.
I hate feeling like that, and I hate being angry at my feelings, and I am so afraid that I am one sleepless night away from spiraling back down into the hell that I just barely dragged myself out of.
That I don't even need insomnia to be kept awake at night. I don't want to go back. One way or another, I'm never going back.